everyone. Today we begin with our second chapter of class 8, Geography, Interior of the Earth. In this lesson, we are going to study about the layers of the earth. The earth's interior can be divided into the following layers: crust, mantle, outer core and inner core. The scientists believe that the earth was formed out of the solar system itself. Initially, earth was a gaseous hot balloon. It cooled down as it rotated around itself. The process of cooling took place from the outer surface towards the earth's center. As a result, the outer layer, which is the crust of the earth, became cooler and solid. But as we move from the surface to the core, heat increases, and at certain depths, the interior of the earth is semi-liquid. Man has always been inquisitive about what lies in the interior of the earth. A direct observation of the earth's interior has not been possible as yet. Through various methods, the scientists have tried to estimate about the same. To infer about this, study of the materials coming out of a volcanic eruption and the seismic waves is most important. Matter coming out of volcanic eruptions consists of hot magma, gases, steam, etc. When lava cools and solidifies, igneous rocks are formed. Through the estimates of the study of temperature, density, gravitational force and pressure, the interior of the earth was understood. For instance, when we go deep into a mine, we feel an increase in temperature. Similarly, the magma coming out of the volcanoes from the earth's interior is hot. Such estimations were made by the geologist. Several earthquakes occur in various places on the earth every year. Seismic waves are generated. These waves travel through the interior of the earth. While going from the earth's surface to its core, major changes occur in temperature and density. With respect to these two elements, the earth's interior can be divided into the following layers. The layer of the interior of the earth is divided into crust, mantle, and core. Crust is further subdivided into continental crust and oceanic crust. Mantle is further divided into upper mantle and lower mantle. Core is further subdivided into outer core and inner core. Now let us understand the layer of the earth, which is crust. The uppermost layer of the earth's surface is in solid state and it is called the crust. The thickness of the crust is not the same everywhere. On an average, it is 30 to 35 kilometer thick. The thickness of the crust below the continents is from 16 to 45 kilometer. 40 kilometer under the mountain ranges and less than 10 kilometer under the oceans. The crust is the thinnest of all the layers when compared to the mantle and the core. It can be divided into two sub-layers, continental crust and oceanic crust. So now let us understand what is continental crust and oceanic crust. Continental crust. The continents are mainly composed of silica and aluminium. Because of the high proportion in this layer, the layer was earlier known as Siyal. The density of continental crust is 2.65 to 2.90 gram per cubic centimeter. The thickness of this layer is approximately 30 kilometers. Granite rocks are mainly found in this layer. Next we come to oceanic crust. This is the second layer of the crust. It is made up of silica and magnesium and was called as Sima. This layer is approximately 7 to 10 km thick. The density of this layer is 2.9 gram per cubic centimeter to 3.3 gram per cubic centimeter. In this layer, basalt and gabbro rocks are mainly found. Always remember, the Earth today is the product of over 4.5 billion years of differentiation into the layers of varying density. The 8 most abundant elements in the Earth are iron, oxygen, silicon, magnesium, sodium, calcium, aluminium, and potassium. These elements are found in the various layers of the Earth's interior. So, in this part, we have studied about crust, and the crust is divided into two, continental crust and oceanic crust. We'll continue in the second part. Thank you very much.